Fala galera do canal, me chamo Juliene. No vídeo de hoje veremos o jornal estadunidense e o jornal mexicano falando sobre a tragédia que aconteceu no Rio Grande do Sul. Mas deixe seu like e inscreva-se no nosso canal para ajudar na divulgação e valeu!
Not only in our city and the country, but flooding in Brazil, crippling the nation as families are displaced and losing everything.
And now organizations in our area are stepping in to just try and help. Good Day Wake Up anchor Dan Bowens joins us right now with his story. Dan.
And there's so many Brazilian Americans who live in our area, whether it's Astoria, Queens, or Ironbound, Newark. So a big concern, no doubt about it, in South America, where a devastating natural disaster is unfolding in Brazil. Historic flooding leaving entire cities underwater. A catastrophic situation and major concern for many Brazilian Americans in our area. Now, one local organization in Newark is stepping up to help. First, let's take a look at some of this damage here. Torrential rains over the last few weeks creating the worst flooding in the country's modern history, impacting nearly the entire southern state of Rio Grande do Sul. At least 100 people are dead and even more are missing. Much of the attention is in the state capital city, Porto Alegre, where heavy rain is forecast for the weekend, so more rain is on the way. Streets there are already submerged, the airport is closed, power is out, and more than 100,000 people had to evacuate their homes. Responding now, a nonprofit in Newark called Mantena Global Care, collecting much-needed supplies. We visited the offices and spoke to the company's CEO.
They need everything. So we're trying to gather the community in here and help them with whatever they need in Brazil in partnership with Azul Airlines and the whole community, the Brazilian community, the Latino community, the American community.
And they are collecting everything from clothing to winter clothes because it is winter in this part of Brazil. They are also looking for hygiene items like toothpaste and other toiletries and things like diapers and baby food. Remember, many people had to evacuate quickly and don't know when they will return. They will drive those goods from their warehouse there in Newark to Florida and fly them on Azul Airlines, the Red Cross in Brazil. While we were there, we saw several people in the local community stepping up to help.
There's a lot of lives being lost, and it hurts me to know that a lot of people that, you know, although are my personal family, but I still feel close to them, knowing that they'll be okay, they'll find me, I can donate for them. It's like trying to help out. That's the end of the day, it doesn't matter where you're coming from.
And we touched on it earlier, but more than 100,000 Brazilians live in New York and New Jersey, especially the Ironbound section of Newark, Astoria, Queens. This area that's affected is about twice as large as what we had here during Hurricane Katrina.
Wow. Ahora nos vamos a Brasil. Aumentó a 100 el número de muertos por las inundaciones en varias ciudades, sobre todo en Río Grande del Sur. En Brasil hay 372 heridos, cientos de casas y edificios de gobierno quedaron bajo el agua. En menos de 5 días, miles de personas han abandonado sus hogares. Las lluvias torrenciales han afectado a más de 1 millón de personas en 385 municipios. La gente está viviendo una pesadilla. Hay poblados incomunicados y, bueno, pues esperan que muchas personas sean rescatadas. Paco, están pasando hasta 2 o 3 días en los techos. Estamos hablando, ayer compartiste un video en Instagram de una jovencita que vive ahí. Dicen, a ver, para que se dé una dimensión del daño, está inundado una superficie similar a todo el territorio de Italia.
Es impresionante, de verdad, o sea, de lo que estamos hablando. Imagínense que esté inundada toda Italia.
Así es.
Y pues ya la incapacidad también de las propias autoridades, están teniendo que hacer otro tipo de cosas, están tratando de pues poner en las redes sociales las fotografías, los datos de los niños que fueron separados de sus padres para tratar de reubicarlos. La verdad es que es una situación de la que no los medios ahorita, como estamos muy ocupados en muchas cosas, no le estamos dando el seguimiento, pero es una tragedia de verdad de dimensiones muy importantes.
Inundaciones que tapan casas hasta de 2 pisos y, como dices, no hay manera de rescatarlos porque no hay caminos, no se pueden comunicar porque no hay electricidad y los celulares se quedaron sin batería, no hay agua, tienen que rescatar a todas esas personas, pero después del rescate viene la limpieza y cómo, digo, nosotros lo supimos en 1985, en el 2017, cómo en segundos puedes perder absolutamente todo tu...
Então, esse vídeo serve de exemplo. Se eu não me engano, essa é uma comunidade brasileira ou latina no geral que está angariando mantimentos, roupas para enviar lá para o Rio Grande do Sul. Ou seja, se você pode ajudar de alguma forma, ajude. Mesmo que seja através do Pix. Porém, é aquela história. Preste bastante atenção para onde você está enviando esse Pix para não cair em nenhum tipo de golpe. Porém, ajude, porque tenho certeza que vai fazer muita diferença por lá. O vídeo foi esse. Deixe seu like, inscreva-se no nosso canal para ajudar na divulgação e valeu!